According to Wikipedia, a tax is a compulsory financial charge or some other type of levy imposed on a taxpayer by a governmental organization in order to fund government spending on various public expenditures. States and their functional equivalents throughout history have used money provided by taxation to carry out many functions. Some of these include expenditures on public transportation, sanitation, legal system, public safety, education, healthcare system, military, scientific research, culture and arts, distribution, data collection, and the operation of the government itself. So the previous time you were here, we gave you an amazing offer on Britaville, and one of our astounding customers have made the place as their kingdom. And as we mentioned in the clauses, our customer support doesn't end when we make sales, but after sales service is what we are known for, and we had a query stating how to make money off the kingdom, though the work is still going on. Good question. We are not really going to use state-of-the-art technology for this, but we shall turn back and look into the past and make the best use of the realty revenue segment. Want a place to reside which is not just built on air and hopes? We use neither, but bricks. Number 1. Brick tax. Introduced in Great Britain, of course, by King George III in 1784 as a means to pay for the war being fought in American colonies. And the reason bricks were chosen to be subject to tax was that there had been significant growth in the popularity of the material in the late 1700s. And earlier, the proposal was perceived as partial and unfair since the parts of Britain mainly used stone for building, and the tax would not apply to the rich, as their houses were built almost exclusively out of stone. Classic government move. The tax was paid at 4 shillings per 1,000 bricks. Clearly, this was not going to be popular. So, to reduce the tax payment, the solution was a simple one. Increase the size of the bricks, so that less of them would be used, and the government responded by limiting the size of the bricks and doubling the tax on bricks that were larger, putting many companies out of business. Do you want a beautiful backyard view, which is filled with greenery and a ray of morning sunshine, along with the singing birds will work as your alarm clock and will make you feel like a Disney prince or princess, which will work charmingly for you to keep your spirit high throughout the day? Yes, sure you can. Just pay the tax for those windows. Number 2. Window tax. Window tax was a property tax based on the number of windows in a house. There was a flat rate of 2 shillings per house. Then to those with larger houses with more windows were penalized a variable rate when the number of windows were above 10, and a colossal 8 shillings when the house had more than 20 windows. The tax was amended several times and often regarded as unfair and seen by some as tax of light and air, and the tax was finally repealed in 1851. Well, it seems like you want the moon to be seen from your bed. Sure you can, you just paid for the windows tax before you. Now enjoy the view and deal with the animals who are willing to move into your room as well. Well, it's nearly bedtime, so time to sleep. Did you just hear time? Number 3. Clock tax. Again, no surprise, in an attempt to generate more revenue for country in 1797, William Pitt imposed yet another tax, the clock tax. And this tax required a payment of 5 shillings on every clock, even within a private home, and 2 shillings and 6 pence on pocket watches of silver or other metal, and 10 shillings on those of gold. We literally have a lot more to say, and these are fine examples we are capable of. Opportunity strikes very few times in life. Make sure you don't miss those odds. And at Different Wisdom Developers, we like to provide many more such odds down the line for those who missed out on earlier ones. We are delighted to welcome you and looking forward to see you at greater heights. You may ask, what if the resident is not willing to pay any tax and you don't want any collateral damage? Slap the heathen with a covered ice tax.